Hey everybody, it's Invicta. It's time to continue our Eden streak here in the Binding of Isaac Victa Afterbirth series. We're sitting at 123 wins in a row and hopefully counting. Let's find out here. Thank you everybody for the support. You appreciate it. The last run was certainly something, and we've got ourselves a little bit of a weird mix of items. You can see today it's going to be 3-2, Charlie Delta, Charlie Mike, Yankee Delta. We've got decent movement speed, decent range, not very good anything else. But we have Dead Sea Strolls and Trolls and Scrolls. Mystery Sack along with the Contract from Below, which is interesting, to say the least. Because, well, I mean, we found an item immediately that's better than Dead Sea Trolls. So, I'm not going to feel bad about that, although it's basically... It's almost not an upgrade, but I guess technically it's a slight upgrade. So, for those of you who don't know what Dead Sea Scrolls do... I have to resist like the temptation of saying trolls every time. I don't know why. It's become common nomenclature of denoting that item anyway. So Dead Sea Scrolls will basically use a random spacebar item out of the entire spacebar item pool in the entire game, meaning that you could get something good or you could get something terrible. So like for example, you can get Kamikaze, or you could get Tammy's Head, or you could get Shoop the Whoop, or you know, the D4, D100, something like that. But we're not going to go that route. At least the poop does have a little bit of advantage of possibly generating a little bit of money. If we do get the wombo combo of Midas Touch, you can use a clever use of game mechanics, because I'm not sure if it's actually officially considered an exploit or not. But you can, if you stand still with Midas Touch and use the poop, it will actually generate, oh my goodness, it will actually generate a golden poop pile, assuming you have not moved literally an inch. And then you can use that to basically farm up, you know, as much money as you can actually muster. So, but let's not get ahead of ourselves here. I wish I did have a bomb so I could get into the secret room. Curse room would also be nice. I'm not going to take the cracked die just because, well... It's not really the worst trinket, but it's also not that great, so. Let me fight Little Horn in one of the easier arenas, to be frank, although I don't really appreciate the Mega Troll Bomb into the Dark Matter Bomb over here. It's okay, though, Little Horn. I almost call him Loki. Yeah, I mean, he does kind of look like Loki, so. But that last run, let's chit-chat about the last run for a little bit, because it was actually, I was curious to see what the reaction would be to getting Isaac's Heart twice, and also I received a lot of surprising comments, I don't want to say comments, but let's say people were surprised that I actually did finally do a reroll of the D100, like, oh, since Victor finally used, like, a reroll. It's like, I'm not honestly opposed to rerolling, it's just that normally... There comes a time when I've gotten a reroll, especially later, like, you know, late in a winning streak, where I've already got my pretty much build set up, and it would be, I don't see any benefit to actually rerolling. Now, I know that you could go for the zaniness, kookiness factor, and I do that sometime, but I'm not going to reroll a winning run. I mean, that's just not something that I'm willing to do. And again, the logic there is that, you know, I challenge people to see if you would actually do that if you were on a, you know, an extended winning streak, because it is a little bit of a tough thing to wrestle with. So we end up getting the toothpicks, which is great. It's gonna give us a tears up, which is something that we definitely needed. And yeah, but that last run, I mean, there's no way I was gonna stick with the combo there that we got after rerolling Epic Fetus. I was kind of okay with staying with Epic Fetus, but I still don't like the item all that much. And anyway, I'm not gonna rehash old stuff other than just saying, you know, again, I'm not completely opposed to rerolling. It just has to, it's got to be the right conditions. You know, if this was a brand new win, or if this was a run, or like a daily run, you know, or a brand new streak, something like that, I would reroll pretty much all day, every day. But that, it didn't make sense to really, it usually does not make sense to roll a winning run, although for the sake of kookiness and blah, 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 so. That's all I'm going to say about that. But again, I do want to say thank you everybody who has been showing support for the Isaac series. I really do appreciate it. The series has been going wonderful so far, and I am looking forward to doing it. Going into the next year for Afterbirth Plus and beyond. Oh my goodness, we're getting so many soul hearts here. Look how much HP we've got. This is a little bit scary. So, Contract from Below, by the way, will double all consumable drops. It's very, very, very similar to Humbling Bundle, except Humbling Bundle only does consumable drops, whereas the Contract from Below not only does consumables, but also does chests and basically gives you more value for everything that drops, put it that way. So, Humbling Bundle is very good combined with Contract from Below. And Mini Mush, you know what? Fine by me. We get a movement speed upgrade. We get a little bit of range. I am happy with that. We get a little bit of a size down as well. And also contributes to the fungi transformation, which is somewhat inconsequential. Man, we're getting so many swords. And I'm not trying to sound complainy or anything. It's just kind of like, good lord, man. Like, it's... I don't think I've ever seen this much HP in 1.5 floors, pretty much. Unless we started with something amazing, which we didn't. I mean, we only started with 1 red heart and 2 soul hearts, so we've just been getting uber lucky. What is our luck stat, by the way? Our luck stat's not that good, so I don't know. Speaking of something that would be good here, if we could get small rock, that would be huge. It would slow us down a little bit, but it would give us a pretty nice damage boost here. This might be a Perthro rune. That would be cool. I would not be opposed to that. I'm going to take the store key for now, just because I would prefer to not have to worry about spending keys for getting into the store. It's going to be a blank rune, which I'm going to hold off on using. So there's car battery here, which is something that I am very interested in picking up. A car battery will basically use our spacebar item twice. And let's see what this tarot card is. It's going to be a moon card. All right, well, I'm going to use the blank rune then. And it was a Perthro, so... Kind of wish I knew, would have known that. Yeah, I'm not going to take Swallow Penny. I mean, to be honest, money should not be a factor in this run just because of the fact we have a contract from below. So, and we were able to buy something. We were able to buy a 15-cent item on floor 2, which is already a leg up on the competition here. I would have liked to have seen what was in that curse room on the first floor, but at the time we didn't have, like... I mean, we had a decent amount of HP, but certainly not one that I'm willing to, you know... There's no reason for me to go in there if I want to protect our deal with the devil. Which we are almost guaranteed to get, unless something catastrophically bad happens on the boss fight. Which, it always could be, you never know. I know it sounds like I'm sandbagging a little bit, but you just never know. Gonna be Haunt, and this is one of those bosses that you just don't know. But I mean, the day that I lose 11 HP to Haunt, especially non-champion Haunt, is the day that I should probably hang up my Isaac shoes. Which doesn't even make sense because Isaac didn't even wear shoes. Like, the only time... Let's try to think about when's the only time that Isaac actually has anything on his feet? Mom's heels are about it. Does he ever have anything else on his feet besides that? I don't think so. I mean, depending on, like, if you consider Guppy's paws to be, like, you know, decorations or articles of clothing, maybe. But, you know, because I guess he does have paws when you turn into Guppy. Look, this is a stupid conversation. What I'm trying to get at is that this Haunt fight should not really be all that difficult. But if I lose to him, I'm not going to be happy. But I'm putting the chance of us losing to this Haunt in particular at literally 0%. I don't know if there's any way I can lose 10.5 hearts. Although I wasn't very happy following that Brimstone shot or that one either. So... What we're looking for, deal with the devil. Honestly, the world is our oyster. It doesn't matter. I would take anything that gives us damage. I'm definitely going to be taking old bandage because it gives us another red heart container. And yeah, we'll just go ahead and take both of these. You know, Brimstone, Lord of the Pit. You know, it's good. You know, Brimstone happening to be my favorite item of all time. And does Brimstone necessarily mean that it's a one run? No, but it's about as it's. Almost a guaranteed one run. I mean, Brimstone's Brimstone. If you don't know what Brimstone is, it is a very powerful hard carry item. My favorite item in the entire game, by far. I voted it number one on my own personal, you know, hard carry items in the Binding of Isaac franchise. And it's all around just a fantastic item. You can't go wrong with Brimstone. Now, there's sometimes a little bit of a reason for me not to pick up Brimstone. In rare cases, I won't pick it up, usually because I have Mom's Knife. Mom's Knife, Brimstone, they do actually synergize together. Instead of a blood laser, it's a bunch of just knives shooting out everywhere. But what I will say is that it, for me, I don't like the way it plays, and I feel that they cancel each other out, kind of in a not good way. Because it definitely drops the damage of Mom's Knife, and it also, in turn, drops the damage of Brimstone. There's some people who will actually completely, like, ignore what I just said and actually try to prove it wrong. You know, I don't know what the exact details are. So the way that I quantify me not taking Mom's Night Brimstone is just that it just doesn't match my playstyle. That's the generic excuse whenever it's... I don't have a solid answer to back up as sort of like numerical values or anything. Like, I can't prove that Brimstone, Mom's Knife actually makes both of them weaker. It's just how it feels, kind of. So, we did get an Eternal Heart for Mystery Sack, which I definitely appreciate, Eternal Heart. I'm not going to go fight the boss yet, because I'd like to find our item room. Playing this Judgment over here is also kind of interesting. I was hoping it would be a Demon Judgment, but not that big of a deal. We get a Sun card, so that's going to be great. As you see here, our damage, even with Brimstone, is not really all that great. I have lost runs with Brimstone before, but that was back in my super early, in the dark days of me playing Isaac, when I was only able to use Brimsnapping as a scared little nerd. Right, so we have enough bombs to sort of be lazy here. We get Blind Rage. Blind Rage is not bad, but it's not what we need. That's a trinket that will increase the invulnerability period after Isaac takes damage by like a half a second. It's very good, especially if you're using Demon Judgments or Blood Banks, but overall, not really something that we need. And yes, I could have saved myself a key if I had simply just gone and picked up the store key trinket that I dropped in favor of getting the counterfeit penny, which is the one we have right now, which will randomize the denomination of the coins on the ground. Kind of a not really discussed trinket all that much, but the counterfeit penny can actually be pretty darn good. It's just one of those items in the game that just makes other items more valuable. In this case, the items that get made more valuable happen to be money. Right there we gain 3 cents off of 2 cents, which is pretty darn good. And we get a forget-me-now. Now I'm curious to see what happens if we end up using this while having the car battery. I'm going to use an educated guess here and say that we are not going to roll double... rooms, or double floors, I should say, but it's still going to, you know, I'm happy to see Forget Me Now. I would like to try to make Boss Rush, but we should definitely keep we should definitely use this Forget Me Now to get another deal with the devil. I mean, that's something that should be done. Alright, so we're going to use pretty much all the money that we can to get a red heart here, hopefully anyway. Because if we do get a deal with the devil, I'd rather take a red heart deal rather than a soul heart deal. Plus, we have this eternal heart that we're going to protect, and we can use that again once we use the forget-me-now. So let's go down to the boss, destroy them really fast, and then after that, we'll probably use forget-me-now on this floor. I don't see any reason not to. This is a very convenient arena for us because Frail can't actually hit us, which I appreciate. Well, now he can, but... What is Frail supposed to be, by the way? I know it has sort of like a fishbone skeleton thing going on, but it also kind of looks like an overgrown silverfish in a way. Which I guess might be the play on the fact that it is a fish skeleton. Fishy-type skeleton, anyway. Because silverfish, it's silver. Look, it makes sense. So we get the halo. And yeah, we're going to take Pact. I'm going to go ahead and hit Forget Me Now. We're going to just do it all over again. So we get damage. We get all stats up. We also have 2 HP now. Not 1. And oh man, we are moving. I am to move it. I like to move it. I don't know. They ever discussed like what the it part of that song was? What exactly are you liking to move? I'm curious. Something that's always perturbed me. This Cursed Eye, which doesn't technically do anything for Brimstone, but I'm not going to take it just because it's freaking Cursed Eye. Why did I go over here? So the Sun card will do a Necronomicon effect and also give you the entire map exposed. And left hand, you know what? I'll take it. We might as well go for a Guppy run here. I am going to go to the store, however. And again, I think that the counterfeit penny is a fantastic trinket. There's no reason for me to not take the counterfeit penny here, but I'm just... At this point, I'm trying to save a little bit of face and say, you know, we took Brimstone. I'm not going to feel bad about it. But I know that some people don't like Brimstone runs because it just tends to mean, like, okay, well, it's just game over. So we're trying to make it interesting for you. But just know that I will almost never turn down Brimstone. Number one, I will take number one. It actually drops the damage of Brimstone a little bit. But the reason why I did that was because in the case that we do get Libra, our huge tiers rate will actually increase the damage overall. I know that that's kind of a stretch, But for the most part, that's the thought process was there. That and Brimstone gets turned yellow now, so. And who doesn't like the color yellow? Unless you're going against a team in X sport that sports the yellow color as their uniform, I don't know. Can I name three teams, no matter the sport, that have a primary yellow color as their team color? Oh man, now I've set myself up for fail here because I'm only going to think about football or baseball. Well, no, that's not true. I guess Golden State Warriors in the NBA. Maybe the Packers. I don't know if the Packers ever had yellow uniforms. I know they've always had green uniforms, but the Steelers, I don't think they actually have yellow on them. That's a tough one. Out of all the teams, or out of all the sports, that's a good Mega Troll Bomb, by the way. I can't really say the 49ers because the Niners kind of have a they've got a more gold thing going on. And by that token, I also can't name the Saints because it's the same thing. It's not really yellow; it's more gold. So all I came up with was Golden State Warriors, maybe the Packers. Think baseball. Let's think baseball here. The Oakland Athletics, they were mostly yellow, a little bit green as well. I can't believe I realize that I'm spacing out on, like, there's got to be at least two other NFL teams that I'm not thinking of off the top of my head that have yellow as a primary color in their logo. I got the Packers. I've got... Not the Seahawks. I can't say the Saints. I don't know. That's a very odd question. I'm not gonna wrestle with this for too long, by the way. Tampa, let's see, Tampa Bay we never really had yellow. It's always been pewter or peach or white. The Rams? Yeah, the Rams definitely, I would say, had yellow at one point or another. Purity, sure. I mean, again, it doesn't really matter. We're moving way too fast, by the way. If we can get Libra, that would actually be huge for us. But, I mean, it's a one run. Let's not beat around the bush. It's now a one run. The fact that we got the pentagram and the pact, you know, we're just blowing through the motions here. As I try to still fumble around the idea of what other teams in any sport has yellow as their primary color. And don't even tell me about hockey. Don't start this hockey business. You want to do that, go to the Eggs channel. He'll be able to rattle off, like, all the colors of the rainbow that the freaking hockey players use. Wow, our tiers rate is just incredible now. Man, that's a really tough question. I'm going to change the subject because I'm just going to wrestle with this for the rest of the stream, and I don't want to do that. By stream, I mean video. Actually, a little bit surprised that the secret room was there. We get a troll bomb for our efforts. Thank you, game. So, I usually don't take key bomb just because I normally need the keys, but the fact that we do have the contract from below kind of swayed my decision on that. Wow, there's been, like, an abundance of soul hearts. Can I name... Let's see if I can name 10... What do you think is the most prolific color in all of professional sports? Doesn't matter the sport. Just in total. I would say probably black and then red. White would probably be... If black is not number one, then I would say white is definitely going to be number one on that. Oh my god, we got super greed right after a greed fight. Oh yeah, we have Keybum. Let's say can I actually name 10 teams? It doesn't matter the teams or the sport that has red in their logo as one of the primary colors. You got Chicago Bulls, you've got Tampa Bay Buccaneers. This is going to be not in order, by the way. Cincinnati Reds, of course. How many is that? That's 4, I think. San Francisco 49ers, 5. My brain is working. It's taking time to translate to an answer here. By the way, I do want to pick up that fool card so we can get to the boss rush and get out of there. Not that we need it, it's just that, you know, it's boss rush. I would like to get another item if possible, but I'm not going to waste this Perthro rune either, especially on Gish. In other words, if I can reroll, you know, Lil Gish, I will. Even though I like Lil Gish, but... okay, so we've got the Bucks, we've got the Reds, the Texans, Chicago Bulls, I realize I just picked up Lil Gish anyway. The San Francisco 49ers, Arizona Cardinals, St. Louis Cardinals. I'm actually gonna re-roll all of these. As much as I like Maw of the Void, we don't need Maw of the Void. We got Rotten Baby. We got Guppy's Hairball, and we also got a Magician card. It's gonna be very close to. I'm gonna try to make Boss Rush if I can, but if we don't make it, it's not that big of a deal. So we have both all the Cardinals teams. Let's go for Think bigger. It's interesting how difficult this question is. I think it's mainly just because of the fact that I'm playing a video game and trying to make commentary while also trying to think. Also, this is the most like ridiculous vault ever. Let's go straight for the boss. Let's see if we can actually get through boss rush. We have less than a minute to do so. But we do have this fool card. Okay. Well, this is apparently the wrong way to go, so that might have sealed the deal here. So we say no thank you to Chubb. This will be a miracle if we actually make this. We're gonna have to get more rooms like that, and less rooms like this. And yeah, I kind of give up on the colors question because it's gonna be a majority of me going, ooh, I can't think of anything, and then you know there's gonna be like no commentary at all. This is what happens when we get a super powerful run. All right, so we got Mom. I mean, it is possible that we can make it. It's gonna be close. We got Small Rock, which I'm super duper happy about. Ironically, if we took Maw of the Void, I may have been able to get it, but yeah. So we get into Boss Rush, Monstro's Tooth, Tech X. The Pupula Duplex and a Dunce Cap. I'm gonna take Tech X, just because it's, you know, Brimstone Tech X is hilarious. A little bit of our HP back here, and yeah, this is me firing as rapid as possible. It almost looks like we have Soy Milk. But that's just because of the amazing amount of tier upgrades that we've gotten. So we also have the red aura, which I believe is the damage aura from Purity. So that's pretty cool. So if I get a chance, would I fight Hush? Sure, we'll fight Hush. If I get a chance and if we have enough HP, which we should. Would I fight Mega Satan? Sure. And again, if the opportunity presents itself. I prefer to have possibly Guppy by then, if possible, but, you know. I'm going to use the Two of Diamonds now. I probably could have waited on doing that to see if we actually do go to Hush. And we'll get Seraphim, which is kind of whatever. He's just going to add a little bit of extra DPS, but for the most part, it doesn't really matter. Go back here and bomb these blue and purple fires here. You do have to be careful because they do shoot, the purple ones anyway, do shoot a homing shot at you. But we are all sorted here, and honestly, I'm happy that we got a run like this. I'm not only stoked because of the fact that I get to play with Brimstone, but also because of the fact that we've been having a couple of really rough goes the past couple of episodes. And that's not to say that, like, I need, like, oh, you know, I need to be coddled. Please, somebody just give me an easy win or anything like that. You know, but it is kind of nice as a change of pace here. That was also a really bad donation machine. All right. Alright, so we're gonna get the cursed chest there, which apparently was left in Mom's room for some reason. Soul Heart here. grab these keys and bombs. Let's see what's up here real quick. I'm hunting for red chests right now because I do want Guppy. Speak of the devil, we got... Okay. Speak of the devil, we've got a devil deal. And by the way, for those of you who don't know what the left hand does, which is the trinket that we've got right now, it will make all chests that drop or appear, they will be red chests or cursed chests. Which gives you a higher chance of getting Guppy items, but also gives you a higher chance of getting, like, you know, spawn spiders and bombs, troll bombs, all the works. Overall, though, if you want to become Guppy, that's what you... It's a good way to do so, especially if you don't have Deal with the Devil precedent. But the downside is that it does turn all your chests into red chests, and most of the time they don't pay out with anything. However, they can pay out, like I said, with aforementioned Guppy items, or Soul Hearts sometimes. Soul Hearts actually appear fairly often out of red chests as well, which is another reason why it's a pretty darn good trinket. Maybe even possibly underestimated a little bit. Undervalued. Not exactly sure what's in this room, so I'm just going to keep doing this. I'm assuming it's Polycephalus. I also don't know why Polycephalus decided to show up right there. I was nowhere near there. Whoa! Okay, did not see that chest at all. Okay, so I need to be a little bit careful here because we are on Curse the Unknown. And I did take Dark Matter, which I didn't really need to do, but I just took it for damage. But the point is that I don't actually know how many Soul Hearts we have left. It's not a lot. I think we might be at 3. So I need to be a little cautious here. But again, our damage is what's going to really carry us through. I also need to... Okay, Blast Assist. Let's not do that. I also need to make sure I drop the... If we fight Hush, however, I am going to have to drop the left hand. Because that is... I want to get those extra items that we can get out of the... or at least the possibility of getting those extra items from Hush's 4 item chests that you get. It's a very odd place for a random red chest to show up from a champion drop. I mean, I'll take it, though. Skolex, not going to be a big deal here with piercing. Thanks to Brimstone. Skolex goes down. Needless to say, we probably don't really need a range upgrade. And we get Guppy's Tail, but again, I can't actually take this because I don't know how much HP we have. I'm almost certain that we only have 3 Soul Hearts. And that kind of pains me not to take that. Yeah, we would have been... Well, we had 4, but we would have been in the danger zone for no reason at all if I took that. So be careful of the blowback there. All right, so we have a 5 room, which is going to restart the floor, which is basically a forget-me-now. So that's good. It gives us extra time to possibly get a deal with the devil. Extra chance of getting more soul hearts via red chests. And, of course, the aforementioned Guppy items, especially. So we get the Pandora's Box, which is going to actually give us, I believe... No, it's just going to do nothing. It gives us the Bible, maybe. Yeah, it does give us the Bible. If we had gotten that a floor earlier, I actually would have been able to get a couple of boss room items out of that. I should also really be letting the key bugger pick up these keys because he could spawn chests that could be red chests like that. And then we could possibly get a Guppy item out of that. I have a vault, and it's going to be a greed fight in the vault, which is very, very odd. Just going to grab the money here. Not that big of a deal. Not going to take any pills. I will say that right now I'm leaning towards the side of not fighting Hush because it does kind of add a little bit of a danger flavor now, but I guess in a run where you have Tech 10 Brimstone or Tech X Brimstone, depending on where you live in the world, you know, we may end up still doing it. I don't know. I'm being a little bit overly cautious right now, but that's only because we're going to do this floor again. With the 5 room, and I'm hoping that we get some a little bit of HP would be nice. That's a good start. This coming from like the fact that we had so much HP after that first floor. All right, so we're gonna lose a soul heart there, which is unfortunate, but that's all right. More keys. I'll go ahead and let Keybeggar take those. It's not gonna spawn us a chest because he's a giant jerk. Thank you, little chest. Our damage is quite good. Oh, you know why that Polycephalus popped up in the other room there? It's because it was feared. That's why. I've solved the mystery that nobody was really questioning about. Alright, no thank you for the spiders. Two hearts, no thanks. We also have tower card, which I probably don't want either. The nice thing about having the Bible, though, is that we don't really have to worry about Mom's heart damaging us, like, literally at all. Because we'll be able to just one-shot her immediately. Secret room might be there, might be here. It's definitely not going to be in here, but that's okay. Alright. Nothing for me, Keybagger. Thanks a lot. Thanks for nothing. Alright, so we did not get a deal with the devil, so we are going to go back to the 5 room and then just do it all over again. So a pretty, like, useless floor, I'm gonna be honest. Like, we didn't really get anything here. We did gain a soul heart. I mean, I'm much more apt to do the hush fight with 5 than I am 3. So let's see if that holds true. So let's head on down and just redo the whole thing again. Hopefully we get a guppy item. That would be nice. 9 lives would make me feel a lot better about fighting Hush. But you get an arcade this time around. This room is just awful. This is one of those rooms that you're just... It's understood that you're going to take a hit. There's not really much you can do about it. Go check out the boss trap room. Still have time to make Hush. I'm not going to try to rush through it. I'm not going to rush for Hush. This could be a big room if we get a nice spawn with the other two chests. We actually stand far, far away from pretty much everything because we have maximum range thanks to Brimstone. That was actually kind of dangerous there. So what I did there and what I mean by dangerous is that don't do what I just did there. You want to make sure that the room is over before opening up red chests, especially because you could get ported out and have to do the entire room over again. Now, obviously, on a run that's as powerful as this, it's not really going to matter. But if that was a life or death situation and you got teleported thanks to, you know, a red chest spawning from wherever, and you had to do that over again, that could be a life and death situation for your run. So don't do that. That was an example of what not to do. And I'm not saying that I did that purposely just to provide an example either. I'm just saying, in hindsight, that was very suboptimal. Because that could have been bad if this were a much more closer run. Am I getting any real good amount of soul hearts to drop here? I'm a little bit concerned. But again, at least I don't have to worry about using... taking any damage on Mom's heart because we've got the Bible, which is just insta-kills Mom. No chest. Come on. All right. Keybagger, listen up. You know, normally I don't give items like you a chance. I'm giving you one right now. You got to start performing, though. You got to start giving me some chests to work with. Because you've been taking all my keys. You've not been providing, really. So, and I'm the breadwinner in this relationship here. Convince me why I need you. There you go. Oh, we traded a tower card for a tower card. That's good. I'm hoping that Fistula could give us a soul heart. It didn't. Super secret room, maybe. All right. Super secret room, maybe. Could be here. And yeah, let's just go fight Mom. Kill her again. Still no deal with the devil, which at this point I'm just taking as a personal insult. And let's just go fight Hush. I'm doing it only because I said I would. Against my better judgment. We don't need to do this, but I'm going to. And I forgot to drop the left hand, so there's that. Alright, Mega Troll Bomb. Regular Troll Bombs. 2 Soul Hearts. And a 3rd Soul Heart. Cool. Alright, oh man, Dry Baby! I'm going to take Cricket's body just because I don't think it does anything for... I'm not entirely sure, but I don't think it does anything for Brimstone. Sorry, Bear is messaging me about something real quick. Bear, if you're listening to this, I've alt-tabbed just for you, Bear. Oh man. I'm so happy to have the friends that I do. I really am lucky. And I'll never take that for granted either. I love all the guys in the NLSS crew. Bear is one of my favorite people. Him and Mathis especially, two of my favorite people ever. So we got Black Candle, which is going to give us curse immunity, which is good. And we also have this Joker card, which I may use versus Hush after we're done. Or I might wait until we get to the Cathedral, because the Cathedral would potentially give us a boss trap room that I can port out, so I can just basically save myself a little bit of time and damage, possibly. But obviously the concern is going to be, if I want to take anything out of the Devil deal, I'm going to have to spend Soul Hearts, and, you know, you've seen, especially with us fighting Hush, you know, we might actually lose a couple here. Also, it's not helping that I can't see half of the tiers because of our Brimstone Tech 10 shots. But, I mean, Hush is going down like a sack of potatoes. This isn't going to be the fastest Hush kill ever, but we're doing pretty good. We've got a pretty good spread of damage. You know, I always laugh at the villain role that Mathis plays in the crew as well. You know, and he does a good job at playing into it as well. I mean, you know, there's got to be a villain. Mathis is strong enough to be that guy, but in reality, Mathis is one of the coolest and funniest people I've ever come to know. And here's also a fun tidbit for anyone out there who cares, which is probably none of you, but the first person that I actually got introduced to all the rest of the NLSS crew through was Mathis. The space food truck video that we did with TB, Total Biscuit, for those of you who don't know that, it was the first time I had actually ever worked on anything officially with Mathis. We had done a couple of Rainbow Six videos with myself, Mathis, TB, and Force. But never really, never anything with NL, and Mathis was sort of my introductory friend to meeting NL, and then I get, you know, the rest is history, of course. But yeah, don't let Mathis fool you with his villain persona. He is a good guy. One of my favorite people in the world. Also one of the funniest dudes I know. So we took a couple of shots there on Hush, which I'm honestly not too proud of. We could have played that a little bit better, but you know, if that's all we get out of that, then you know, not that big of a deal. But we may have hurt our chances of getting a Devil deal on this floor. Not that we would get a Devil deal anyway, but you know what I mean. We have the Force Devil deal here from the Joker card, so Champion Gertie should give us a Soul Heart, and she did. Oh, and we get Curved Horn. Okay, well, we're gonna be leaving this floor with Curved Horn. We're not gonna be leaving here with the left hand, unless if I get a Guppy. I don't want to give an ultimatum. We don't need the damage from Curved Horn. I just like having it. Let's put it this way. If we get a Guppy item out of this Devil deal and I take it, then I will keep the left hand through the chest. Let's put it that way. But if we don't get a Guppy item out of this Devil deal, then I'm going to roll with the Curved Horn at that point. Again, not that we need either one, but I would like to possibly get Guppy since it's been a while. That and Tech 10 Brimstone Guppy is just hilariously overpowered. Tech X, Tech 10. I know people were gonna call me out on that. Yeah, we're not taking BBF. Sorry. we just, that's something I can't. I'll do anything for Guppy, but I won't do that. I will, however, use a Soul Heart to get in this curse room just to see what's crack-a-lacking in here. It's gonna be two curse chests. Let's go ahead and make it three curse chests. And all right, we got one Soul Heart out of it, no problem. Let's go see what's inside of our Joker deal here. And we got a Soul Heart, and that's about it. All right, so we're gonna, unless if we get a red chest from here up until Isaac, I'm not gonna be rolling with the red hand, left hand. Channeling some August Burns Red there for a second. Cane to the Rye, don't really need it. I actually forgot that we picked up the compass. I was wondering where this compass effect was coming from. That seems so long ago. 30 minutes ago. Get more Soul Hearts. Again, right now you're seeing the benefit of actually having the left hand on you is because of its penchant to actually cause chests that give you Soul Hearts. You don't get Soul Hearts this often out of golden chests, that's for sure. There we go. Alright, so we'll go. Go back and grab the Curved Horn real fast. I'm curious to see what we get out of the chest here. Actually, you know what? I'm not gonna grab the curved curve form. It's going to drop left hand. There we go. There's no reason for me to go back there. Look, I love the curved horn. It's the best trick in the game by far, in my opinion. But there's no reason to. We don't technically need it. Also, that was a nice shot there by Isaac. One thing I will say I have to be careful about is using the Bible. I need to make sure I do not use the Bible anywhere near the Isaac fight or the Blue Baby fight, because Isaac actually will die, and I'm not talking about Isaac the boss. I'm saying we will die. Serious Liquid, Sticky or not Sticky Bombs. It's Sticky Bombs. It is Sticky Bomb. Never mind. We also got the Seraphim transformation, by the way. I will take Fruitcake just because it doesn't really matter. And it looks like we did get the damage up. It's okay, game. Sure, I'll take 9 lives. Why not? Make me look like a bigger idiot than I am. Sure. So we get 9 lives out of nowhere. I think Ultra Pride or Super Pride dropped that. Apparently, this is also the wrong way to go. Oh, darn. We'll have to play more Brimstone Tech X. Whatever we do. Yeah, we'll take the Relic. I mean, Tech 1, sure. It might kill our damage a little bit, but look how fast we... It looks like we have Tech 2 because we're firing so fast. Our tears rate is unbelievably high. So we basically can deal damage while we're charging our Brimstone shots, which is a very nice thing to have. Yeah, our damage is just sick. And again, remember, we do also have a Lump of Coal, which is going to be increasing the amount of damage that we do as it travels over time. At least I'm 80% sure that Lump of Coal does synergize with Brimstone. Not 100% sure on that. There's been conflicting reports. Some say it does, some say it doesn't. Give that to Keybagger. Nope. Okay. So, but a very fun run nonetheless. I also want to take this opportunity to say again, thank you very much for the support on the Isaac series. I do have plans for a second series coming very soon. And it's one that I've alluded to before, talking about the fan. Why did the Bible pop there? That actually scared me a whole lot. I mean, we have 9 lives, so even if we died, I would have been able to do it. But that was very weird. Apparently, I used the Bible right before that happened. But yeah, so I am going to be doing a second Isaac series soon. I'm not talking about the top 10 list either. There is something that I've alluded to with the fan-submitted seeds. I just haven't gotten all planned out yet. So it's in the works. But again, thank you all very much for the support. Do appreciate it. If you enjoyed what you saw, kindly consider subscribing here on YouTube. Leave a comment, drop a favorite, drop a like, all that kind of good stuff. It goes a long way supporting your favorite YouTubers. 124 and 0 and still counting. As always, I'll see you all in the next video. Until then, so long, everybody!